Okay, Debbie. You got this. So you got situated back there?
Yeah. Shoot, it's only been like a few minutes since I left. My ramen noodles are still warm.
Wow.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's really weird. Sometimes I come back like a few days later. Sometimes like one time I came back like 2 weeks later, but
yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, we've never actually both been in the Narnia zone together.
Huh. Interesting.
Yeah. I mean, I think there's just, like, too many weird things going on to explain. Is that a chainsaw embedded in that zombie and then through the windshield of that truck?
That is.
That is the most awesome thing I have ever seen.
Let me see if it still works.
Yeah!
Nice.
Oh, that's so good. How is it killing faster
than...
Oh, shit.
I think maybe it's like something mystical, because I am putting some anima into it. It thinks the anima is like, these are, oh, zombies die to chainsaws, of course.
Oh, duh, duh.
I wonder if this thing, if I could just like make this an anima weapon, that would be awesome.
I don't know, I mean, I kind of think that seems like it might be more trouble than it's worth.
I don't know what abilities might unlock if I actually figure it out.
I guess we'll just have to wait and see in case something like that becomes reality.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. Wow, these are like half frozen still. They must have come a long way.
Local bounty detected. Initiating.
Yeah.
Yeah, get some!
This is a pretty badass anima weapon. These zombies are like half frozen.
Hmm.
So they must have come a pretty long way.
I guess so. I mean, they're... Maybe the drog, like, we're all hiding in an iceberg or something.
Maybe.
Oh, good. Another one of these.
Oh, the chainsaw fell apart. I guess it couldn't stand up to it.
Man, that's the downside of chainsaws.
Yeah.
Not actually intended to be melee weapons.
Maybe a bone saw. A chainsaw. Bone saw, maybe? Maybe like a chainsaw, but like with a bone saw?
Maybe.
Because that...
No?
Yeah. Talk to Dr. Aldini about that.
But talk to who?
Dr. Aldini.
Who dat?
Oh, you know that really creepy graffiti near the Illuminati that we didn't actually place there that has like the guy with the... A scarred up face holding a scalpel.
I'm beginning to get a picture of who Dr. Aldini is.
No, wait, look outside your window.
Yeah, I'm seeing... Oh.
I've seen the Frankenstein thing? Yeah, that's him.
Okay.
He does plastic surgery.
Really?
But, like, magical plastic surgery.
Of course, that makes it easier to take.
Using magic and, mad science together.
Because why use any other kind of science?
I patronize the arts and sciences. Dark and mad, respectively.
I see you're a woman of culture as well.
Yes. Look at this tunnel. This tunnel... What if... Whoa, hello.
Oh, that is some Silent Hill shit.
No. Oh. That's far. That's smoke. That is some thick smoke. Toxic fumes, too.
I will never understand what does and doesn't affect you.
I will never understand that either. Well, that gets in my lungs, but then again, why does smoking not hurt me? Huh.
Oh, that's the thing. I mean, smoking's always been good for you, but the Illuminati's just trying to keep, you know, that knowledge out of the public's hands.
Really? I thought they would make like a butt ton of money off of it.
Yeah, but this is one of those things where they don't want people to get too healthy.
Amazing. All right, now I can get through the tunnel, probably.
All right. Just gotta get around the cement truck.
I can teleport, too, so...
Well, still, I mean... It's a good deed done. You'll get a merit badge.
Good deed done, yeah.
My team and I... Well, not my team, per se, more like Ernesto's team. Frank was his second in command. He's such a sycophant. Was a sycophant. I held up the rear, so to speak. Not the flashiest role, but an important member of our three-man and a woman team. Anyway, my team was sent here to work with the Arachi to investigate the filth. A couple of days later, the fog rolls in. This massive wall moving faster than storm clouds. Thank God we had our suits. Made us immune to the airborne agents. Ernesto, the idiot, bless his soul, took his mask off. His eyes just glazed over. His tongue flopped out and he started walking. We couldn't stop him. He just kept walking right down to the ocean, into the water, under the water.
Oh, man.
Next day, he came back up. It wasn't pretty. But at least we'd survived the worst. Help would come. It was just a question of time. We were government employees. Leave no man behind, right? That's all it took. It seeped right through. The guys tried to fight it, but it took just seconds before they were tainted, transformed. I ran as fast as I could, as far as I could. It's spreading. I've seen it on trees, on vegetation, on animals. There was this raccoon the other day. It had glowing eyes, worms protruding from its ears.
Oh, God.
Black ooze leaking through the fur. It left wet paw prints on the ground. And right away, the grass and ground were infected. Strangest thing of all, it was like I could see straight through it. And I could see stars. Dying stars.
Okay.
I know. Doesn't make sense.
Nope.
I need some sleep. It's not easy in this suit. But I am never taking it off.
How does this stuff keep getting worse?
I don't know.
There's something odd going on here. I'm not talking about the fog or Bigfoot or those giant squid things. Did you see that creature with the lobster claws? I mean, holy crap. What is that? What's up with those claws? That's just weird.
Plain damn weird.
Too weird.
Plain damn weird.
It's like a giant lobster man. Sounds scary. That's just freaky. No, I'm talking about the Arachi group. They're up to something. Doesn't it strike you a bit strange that they set up camp just days before the fog came? Convenient. When they shipped us in together with the group, we were the official first response unit. The Arachi guys didn't say one word to us, didn't even acknowledge us. I think they're using us as cover. Seriously, I'm part of a government cover-up. My dad is going to be so disappointed with me. Well, when my team was infected with the filth, did the group offer any help? They locked their gates and shut down the link. I tried calling home. You're on your own, Marianne. That's the only reply I get from Atlanta. Hold tight, sport. The president's counting on you. Really? The president? How dumb do you think I am? No.
Smart in the precedent.
There'll be a mess waiting for me when I get home. If I get home. And I don't care. I'll be happy to just put my feet up and watch some TV. I don't want to be the kind of person the president has to count on in a situation like this. But I bet you
can.
Oh, God.
She can never know.
She's going to stay in 2012 forever. It was a happier time.
Gangnam Style will never die.
Yeah! This is what life is now, and what it shall always be forever.
Yes, this dance will never get old.
Hey, sexy lady, that'll always be funny and not inappropriate.
Yeah.
Psy's gonna have, like, so many hits.
Oh, yes. How about that Psy channel? Awesome, that's gonna be around forever.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, where I watch all those videos.
All that good content.
Gonna be around forever.
I'm gonna have so many movies with the Nostalgia Critic where they all hang out together and are friends.
Yes, this will definitely happen. I miss 2012.
Yeah, me too. But hey, you know, Infinity War.
Yeah, that's coming out soon, isn't it?
And Deadpool 2.
Cool.
I mean, Deadpool 2 as well.
Oh, how slick was that? 0943786.
You just pickpocketed a corpse being eaten by a zombie without the zombie knowing. Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's like 3 natural 20s in a row.
Wait, what was the number?
I forget.
Oh, goddammit.
I was too busy being impressed. No, don't worry, I can just rewind my feed. 0943786.
Okay, that's what I thought it was.
Oh wait, if you put that in, it sounds like the movie, Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
Oh my gosh, I didn't notice that. That's nice.
Mm-hmm.
So you know what hydrogen sulfide is? All right, hold on a second.
Let me check. It's like hair care, isn't it?
I don't know. I like the kind of girl who does that.
No. Moving on. So, hydrogen sulfide. Okay, well, got the triple crown here. Poisonous, corrosive, and flammable.
Wow. Okay, yeah. Like, how poisonous? Like,
I don't know. I mean, is there a... Oh, okay, here we go. I got that little charty thing. Very short exposure could cause death or major residual injury. It's about the same level of deadly as cyanide or hydrofluoric acid.
Jeez.
Will rapidly or completely vaporize at normal atmospheric pressure or temperatures. Flashpoint below room temperature. Good news. Normally stable. Not reactive with water.
Well, that's great. So, but, like, you said it disperses quickly?
Yeah.
I want to get into this.
It's a gas, so, like, you just spray it and everything dies.
Huh. Well, better not use that. How am I going to get into here? So you gotta get away in the science barracks here because they're doing some. They're up to something.
Up to some science. Up to some mad science, yo. Some wicked radical science.
I wonder. You think that everyone get out of there in time?
Probably not, if I'm being honest.
Maybe just a little bit?
Yeah, just a little hydrogen sulfide.
Let's try just a little bit.
Gas leak detected.
Oh, see, they got some instantaneous.
Evacuate laboratory immediately.
Oh, they... Yeah, they seem to have gotten out of there, like, instantaneously. Wow.
Yep.
So I guess I can go in here and, oh! Fucking hell!
Oh, yeah, that's that good rotten egg smell.
My God. I'm dying.
Flip the Five of Pentacles. The teal serpent head, Anansi Technologies. The upright position. Anansi is a high-profile computer software and hardware company. Their flashy retail stores, sleek operating systems, game consoles, mobile phones, and multimedia players are found around the globe. The reverse position. Conspiracy theorist websites and newsletters claim that Anansi is storing information and tracking users through their hyper-modern mobile phones and laptops, and conditioning the minds of the masses through games and subliminal control. Anansi's PR department ignores the allegations. The newsletters abruptly cease and the websites close down.
I gotta get... Henry 5621!
Henry 5621.
I'm dead.
Oh no. Oh, well, that could have gone better.
You got the password before I died, right?
Henry 5621.
Okay.
That is an odd sentence to say.
I have a lot of odd sentences.
Yeah.
A lot of weird and unique sentences come up in this business.
Yes.
Like, there's a conspiracy in the Illuminati. Or like... I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm sure you got some.
I mean, it's just kind of... You know, at this point, it all just feels normal. 09...
09...
4...
4
3...
3 0, wait, 7, 8, 6.
Mm-hmm. Oh shit, gotta hurry.
Or just do it again.
Yeah, or that. They'll just be like...
I wonder if they get suspicious if I keep putting hydrogen cyanide in there.
They'll just be, oh, come on. Twice in one day, guys? We didn't even get to reset the sign yet.
Gas leak has been neutralized. Laboratory atmosphere has been stabilized. Employees can return to their stations. Gas leak detected. Atmosphere unstable. Evacuate laboratory immediately.
Jerry, what the hell? There's always a Jerry.
There's always a Jerry. Oh, God. Yep. Okay.
Henry, what? Henry 5621.
Wait, 5621.
Yep.
Somebody... Okay, I'm just gonna take screenshots.
Okay.
I'm out.
All right.
Get me out of here. Yep.
Access granted. Prometheus Initiative Research Terminal online. Subject 0. Subject exposed without protection to pure filth source. Filth metastasis approximately 150 greater than observed with control experiments. 1 hour, complete cellular takeover. 2 hours, recovery from initial allergic cardiac arrest and brain death. 4 hours, brainwave activity spike indicates multiple consciousnesses. 8 hours, network of pseudopods now extruding from body. Ghost has downloaded this information as an email attachment.
Whoa. Okay, there's a lot of whoa there. A lot of yikes.
Yeah. And a few holy shit, maybe?
Yeah, but... Okay, so the yikes. They're doing these experiments on people. Yeah. Yikes. And the tentacles, that's a yikes.
Yeah, the big yikes. Big yikes for the tentacles.
The whoa is the multiple consciousnesses.
That's pretty fucked.
Okay, I mean, so it looks like this is the best place to transmit the data. I mean, apparently it's too much for me to actually just upload for my you know, iPhone, but...
I mean, this is 2012, remember? You gotta use archaic technology.
But there's somebody in there, and they don't think she... Don't let me by. Oh. I got an idea.
Great security!
Oops, let me get out of here. Before she catches me. Oh.
Oop.
Air stabilizers activated. Laboratory atmosphere will return to normal in approximately 30 seconds.
Well,
at least they didn't catch you until after you had completed all your mission stuff.
You might think running a shadow conspiracy makes us more sympathetic to other shadow conspiracies. It doesn't. Not even a little bit. This news ruins our day as much as any of the suckers on that rock. The ones that have survived, anyway. What were Orochi thinking with all this stuff? Weaponization? It's not like they have to put any effort into that. It's already good to go, and now it has gone. Our analysts are going to bone up on your stolen data, but if you follow Orochi down the hole that they dug themselves, make sure to hold your breath. Wow, does she have standards?
I would never have guessed.
Wait a minute, I have another dossier.
Oh, yeah.
Lydia Darling, a subject has spent most of her life defying her last name, accruing a long list of legal infractions. Subject evinces a macabre demeanor, belongs to the local cult scene, and claims to talk to spiders. During a recent seance, Lydia became possessed by the spirit of her great-grandmother, Ligia Darling, a feared witch with influence in both kinds of underworld and a legendary thirst for rum. Cedric habitually watches the TV show Glee, but doesn't want her coven to know. Use this as leverage, or rum. Wow, it's like outing somebody as a brony, you know, for witches.
Which is more embarrassing?
Always brony.
Yeah.
No, wait, Glee is pretty embarrassing, though.
Yeah. I mean, you know, they're basically the same thing, except that one's actually a cartoon, so that kind of matches the tone of things.
The illuminated concern with the Morning Light's recruitment of high-powered celebrities. Several top-tier actors are known to be members of the cult. The Illuminati will abduct several simultaneously to be reconditioned as sleeper agents. The Morning Light, of course, must not know. To that end, the Illuminati wants to replace the actors with decoys. For this very odd job, they prefer hire highly expendable outside contractors. Okay.
I don't even know what to say about that.
Dr. Ardini, you know, the noted insane surgeon.
Does everybody know about this guy but me?
He lives right across from you.
You've met me. How often do you think I go out?
Good point.
Honestly, this is the most socialization I've had in years.
Oh, send Uderia. So, several top-tier actors, members... Okay, so I'm going to be abducting and brainwashing people. That's pretty bad, but... Then, again, they're going to be abducted and brainwashed anyway. So, better?
LarryDavid.gif.
I guess better us than the morning light. Right?
It is sad that I agree with that.
Dante? Let's find something she can do.
Yeah. Or, you know, dear sweet cinnamon roll faction recruit can't do everything.
Hey, you know what? Let's do a good deed for the day.
All right, what do we do?
Looks like they're having some trouble cleaning up at the Kingsmouth Sheriff Station. go clean it up. You're helping.
Yeah, I mean, you could probably go do that yourself, but...
I'm doing other stuff. It's important.
Shit.
You know, I'm doing big stuff. Big important things.